University of Kelaniya, Sri Lanka has a history of more than 70 years. Faculty of Medicine, University of Kelaniya was established in 1992 and it has a history of more than 30 years by now. We offer MBBS degree program as well as Bachelor of Science degrees in speech therapy, audiology and occupational therapy. And we started the speech and hearing sciences program about 15 years ago. We also entertain Sri Lankan and international students. We have an experience of having international students more than 10 years in our MBBS program. The faculty has created an environment for students to pursue their learning in a rich educational environment, comfortable setting and a friendly atmosphere. We have created an inclusive culture and we respect diversity and we always try to help our students to achieve their extracurricular and co-curricular activities.
The rich collection of extracurricular and co-curricular activities made available at the faculty includes community-based work, sport, and aesthetics. These offer students the opportunity for their personal and social development and nurtures essential life skills in the graduate. The Department of Disability Studies at the Faculty of Medicine, University of Kelaniya, was established in the year 2009, marking a pioneering milestone as the first department of its kind within a state university in Sri Lanka. Since 2008, it remains the sole department offering professional qualifications in speech therapy, audiology, and occupational therapy. Established in 2019, Ayathi National Centre for Children with Disabilities is the department's primary clinical training centre, providing services to children with disabilities across Sri Lanka within a multidisciplinary clinical setting. Clinical training is also provided at hospitals, private clinics, and educational institutions.
The Department of Disability Studies is the only department attached to a state university offering undergraduate courses in speech therapy, audiology and occupational therapy. The courses are taught by experts who are pioneers and leaders in their fields. We promote independent adult learning together with a highly skilled clinical training in order to produce what we call an internationally marketable graduate or an export quality graduate. At the department, we are committed to upholding the medical faculty's vision of delivering globally comparable academic, clinical, and research skills entailed within a holistic undergraduate learning experience with the aim of producing a dedicated and compassionate healthcare professional. Disability is not for the faint-hearted. It is a choice made by those with a self-grown passion to work with one of society's most vulnerable groups.
Speech and language therapy is a globally recognized healthcare profession. Their services entail providing comprehensive care to both pediatric and adult patients facing challenges related to communication, literacy, and swallowing. Long-term rehabilitation goals may involve the restoration or compensation of impaired skills and functions, or, in severe cases, the introduction of alternative communication or swallowing methods.
Who are these people with disabilities or children with disabilities? There are various conditions such as autism, cerebral palsy, learning disabilities, different types of syndromic conditions, hearing impairment, speech and communication difficulties such as stuttering, and also many adult conditions such as stroke and multiple neurological conditions. You will be working in a multidisciplinary environment. By working in such an environment, you will get the clinical expertise, and also you will learn how to approach these people and children with disabilities so that you will ensure fair participation of these people, ensuring their human rights.
The taught content of the course is embedded within a combination of linguistics, psychology, neurology, pediatrics, and research methodology, with an ongoing clinical training during the 4 years of study. Speech-language therapy is a field that is highly in demand, with multiple career prospects, both locally and internationally.
The field of audiology, which gained prominence after World War II, is a specialized field dedicated to addressing disorders related to the human hearing and balance systems. Audiologists undergo comprehensive training to prevent, diagnose, and manage difficulties related to hearing and balance, and are trained in the fitting and management of assistive listening devices like hearing aids. They also contribute their expertise to various other specialized areas, including industrial hearing conservation and newborn hearing screening. At the IIT Centre, we offer a cutting-edge clinical facility that is fully equipped to provide hands-on training for audiology students.
Audiologists provide non-medical treatment to those with hearing loss and involved in prevention of related damage. By employing various testing strategies, such as behavioral and electrophysiological tests, audiologists aim to determine whether someone has normal sensitivity to sounds. The audiologist will provide recommendations for intervention or rehabilitation, such as hearing aids, cochlear implants, auditory verbal therapy, and appropriate medical referrals if medical or surgical intervention is needed. To obtain the degree, subjects like auditory physiology, pediatrics, neurology, psychology, acoustics and electronics, principles and procedures of different hearing tests, hearing aids, implantable devices, and how hearing loss affects development and day-to-day functioning across age ranges need to be thoroughly understood.
Occupational therapy emerged as a profession in the earlier 20th century. Occupational therapists focus on preventing disabilities resulting from illness or injury and work to restore life skills, enabling individuals with diverse physical and mental disabilities to attain independence. Similar to speech-language therapy and audiology programs, the University of Kalaniya's medical faculty is the only institution offering a professional qualification in occupational therapy.
When a patient is referred to occupational therapy, that a thorough assessment is conducted. In the assessment, it is identified the person's body functions, participation, and also environmental barriers. Based on the assessment, occupational therapists plan a treatment. Occupational therapy treatment media is mainly therapeutic activities. In addition to therapeutic activities, physical and mental exercises and various equipment and modalities are used. Occupational therapy is a dynamic and evolving profession which is responsive to the changes taken place in the society, such as aging population and increase in disability among people. If you have a strong sense of empathy and compassion, you can consider occupational therapy as a lifelong career.
The speech and language therapy, audiology, and occupational therapy courses award honors degrees requiring students to undertake a compulsory research project in their respective specialities during their final year of study. All academic teaching, examinations, and research work are conducted only in English. Clinical training requires interactions with patients who speak English, Tamil and Sinhala. All three undergraduate programs are professional qualifications. Upon completion of these programs, graduates become eligible for registration with the Sri Lanka Medical Council. This registration enables them to practice in government and private settings, as well as in private practice settings. We trust that your commitment to serving individuals with disabilities will inspire you to pursue these professional programs. We look forward to welcoming you to the Department of Disability Studies. For detailed eligibility criteria, course outlines and related information, please refer to the UGC Handbook, UGC website and our department's website.